Hello, Malt Muffins. Ralphie here, and this must be number 52. And we are on location, because I know you like it, and we're at McTeers, the auctioneers, in Drumoyne. And can you believe it? Sunny Glasgow. What a change that makes. There we go. McTeers. Through the door we go. Now, just to explain, Andy, the whiskey valuer, has got an auction happening in a couple of days. Hi there. And I'm just recording a wee bit for you guys. Rather than me asking him questions, he's just going to show us around the shelves and go through about a dozen or so bottles which are collectible and briefly give an explanation how much we're looking at. Meanwhile, here is the shelf here. Rosebank, Bowmore's, Talisker, all good stuff. Hello there. Through the cafeteria, there we are. If you wish a latte, this is the place to get. All the seats are laid out. I love a few tasteful and tasteless pictures up in the wall. Hello, Andrew. Yo-ho. Hi, Teo.
Hey, Ralphie, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Back again?
Yes, back again. But it's your turn this time. I'm not going to ask you questions. Very simple. We're a minute and a half into this video, but you've got about 8 minutes, so a good length of time, just to show us round your shelves for the auction in a couple of days.
Sure.
So basically, you know what interests people, you know the price, show us what you've got.
Sure. Well, for those of you who don't know, my name is Andrew, and I'm the Tiro's Whisky Specialist. My job is to set up and control the whisky auctions. We have 4 a year, and let me just show you some more interesting bottles. So I know that's what you prefer. 114 Glogues Perth Whisky, 1929 Glen Grant Pure Highland Malt. Glogues, as most of you will know, is Matthew Glogue of famous Grouse fame. Glen Grant's not one of his famous distilleries, but right there we have something distilled probably just at, say, the cusp of the start of the end of the real whisky time. But after all the culling of all the distilleries by the Diageo guys. Not Diageo guys, sorry.
No.
The pre-Diageo guys, we shall call them.
UD, United Distillers.
It's even probably back before that. It's back with Sir Henry William Ross was in charge of those.
So, right.
That's a lovely bottle. I mean, a lot of time people are really looking for older vintages, older styles of distillation. I think we crossed on that last time you were in. And that's still what people are really going for. That bottle should be £400 or £500, hopefully more by the time that we finished.
Mm-hmm.
If I take you around the corner this way.
Yep.
We have some of the classic bottles that some people might recognise. The Flora and Fauna range, from the cash strength vintage ones, limited edition, through to the regular Flora and Faunas, all different varieties. Some very collectible, the Kalila 15-year-old, one of the harder ones to find. But right at the end of the line, same whisky, same range, wooden boxes. I'm expecting this lot to be at least £500. You can get five of them without the boxes for maybe £200 to £300. With the wooden boxes, you're up to £500.
Mm-hmm.
Very collectible. People really search to put their collection together.
Yeah.
Now, I'll probably just jump to my favourite lot, the mm-hmm. star of the show.
Right, so. Ooh, here it goes. Hold it still, hold it still. There we go. That is a miniature.
It is a miniature. evaporated.
Stating the bleeding obvious here, so I am.
There's a bit of evaporation as well, but this is the famous Springbank 1919.
Right,
distilled 1919,
uh-huh.
For the collection maniacs. It's bottle number 19, bottled in 1969,
mm-hmm.
50-year-old Springbank.
Miniatures are go-go.
Yep.
Now you've got a wee letter of provenance there,
letter
is it?
Authenticity, and...
from Eaglesomes, who are still in the go.
Favourite one is the light bulb box that it was sent up in.
Oh, right.
luckily, the person who owned this knew what it was, but they didn't realise it was going to be worth over £1,000.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow's auction, I'm expecting £1,200 in that miniature alone.
There you go. Uh-huh. And quite a range of miniatures here.
Yes.
And including this shelf here, just quickly scan it.
Miniatures are very collectible. I mean, there's a whole range of the miniature bottle clubs, small whisky clubs,
mm-hmm.
who really go for miniatures, and they really search out to complete their mm-hmm. collections. It's quite a good wee investment to get a good few miniatures and put them aside. They don't always increase in value as much as the rare malt, single malts, but they do actually still have a lot of intrinsic value to them. And at the end of the day, if nothing happens, you've still got a nice wee glass of whiskey.
Absolutely. Halfway through now, next.
I'll keep just walking you through the aisles and back to roughly where we started. We've got some strange selections now. Not the most collectible. probably about £135.
Right.
But I just love the size of it. 2 litre decanter jug.
With a
stopper.
Stopper.
Fantastic. I'll put that. Oops, put that stopper in there.
Bottled by Gorham McPhail's and Elgin to celebrate the millennium.
Uh-huh.
All the whiskies in this bottle add up to 2,000. So I think you've got some good 35-year-old, 45-year-old in there, mixed in with a large number of 20s, 30s, 15-year-olds. Ultimately, 2,000 and bottled for the millennium.
Mm-hmm. And it will keep a door open.
It'll keep a door open. And we'll just pop that one down there. Moving along, we have, as ever, the rare malt selections.
Mm-hmm.
The Abbott figure.
Mm-hmm.
Abbott's Choice, a very old blend, very popular.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the steals of the auction, in my opinion. I've seen them on websites for sale for up to £600.
Mm-hmm.
But you can take away both those bottles for about £60 to £100 tomorrow.
Right. Right, some fine old blend of single malts, you know. I mean, you're going back decades here, it's fantastic.
It's a whole history in a room.
Yeah, next.
Next, we're going to have around here one of my favourite selections.
Mm-hmm.
Just for getting a little bit of history that's not yet occurred.
Right,
but
catching the light, yeah, sun's getting.
Needs no introduction to Blair Athol and Dufftown,
mm-hmm.
but these are back for when things were really advertised, as from the House of Bells.
Uh-huh.
Little Mill, just a wee bit add in there for thing.
Yeah.
But Bell's Islander. I mean,
I remember that.
Yeah. Nice mix of Talisker, Clela Lagavulin, all put together for an absolutely beautiful drink.
And an old Highland Park there.
Okay. I'll see
you tomorrow. 7:30. It's getting told I start at 7:30 in the morning there. A strange one, see if any of you recognise that bottle.
Let's hold it still, hold it still. Jackson's Row. Now that's a location. I'm thinking Highland Park.
No.
It says Duren Sons. Right, okay, it's not Highland Park. Give us a clue, give us a clue. Glenkinchy.
This is the All Blonde Malt. This was pretty much released around the same time as Loch Doo's Black Malt.
Right.
This is the younger, lighter brother. Again, I believe it was an extra distillation to rip the colour out of it, much like the St. Kella malts from the Isle of Man.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, it's against the rules of malt whisky, so it was released for a very limited run and then stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I've got the estimate of 80 to 120, and I'm looking for hopefully close to £200 for such a limited bottle.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Righto.
Anything else that interests us?
Us anoraks and squirrels.
Yes, there's always sort of bottles. I mean, for a pure example of old single malt labels, which is one of the best things to come to Knoxford for, is even just to see these bottles. Glen Grant 5-year-old for the Italian market, Abler VOHM, the old Cardew 12.
That is such a ringer for brandy.
Yeah.
The whole presentation, everything about it.
Absolutely. I think it was mostly designed for the French market in that way, as it could sit easily on your shelves with that.
Mm-hmm.
Also have the Glen Elgin, bit of an older label for the Glen Dronach, recently reopened, and I can't wait to try some of the new ranges.
Cannot wait.
Glen Grant, Glen Forest, and then a little bit of a jump to a blend with the Royal Household by John Buchanan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you've got the certainly expected, plenty of the expected ones, your Macallans, your Glenmorangie Hermitage, Blue Label, of course, and of course, important to sweeping round here. I'm sure I saw a fine old Bowmore. Here was a Bowmore 25. They're still Bowmores, very collectible. Macallan's Fine Oak, and there's a Easter Eccles. Mm-hmm.
Now Macallan is one of the most collectible malt whiskies in the world. If you can get some official bottle of Macallan, I'd get it and hold on to it.
Righto.
The more limited and more rarer, the better.
Right, if you'd just like to conclude now, please, Andy.
Just to conclude that the auction will be tomorrow, Wednesday the 13th of May. If you miss it, you can still contact me and see what the price any of these bottles went for, but you can view all of the results on the McTeers website.
Well, if you miss the auction, there's plenty more auctions coming along, so just keep an eye on things. And a big thank you to Andy here. He's just going to conclude very, very quickly. I put him under a big amount of pressure here. 3 hot tips for enjoying whiskey.
Pick your own whisky, don't let anybody tell you what to do with them, and make it a double.
Man's a pro. Okay. So, McTeers, just Google McTeers Whisky Auctions, you'll find it no problem. And also, if you want to find me and what I'm up to, ralphie.com, R-A-L-F-Y.com. So thank you. It's goodbye from him, and it's goodbye from
him.
That's us. Fantastic. It's in the can. Yeah. No dress rehearsals, nothing.
Just straight into it. Right, we better get it before we chucked out.